Good morning, students. I have worked out some problems on tangents and normal in the earlier sessions. First, I gave you the geometrical meaning of dy by dx, which is nothing but the slope of the tangent. And then for a 1 mark question, only the slope of the tangent or the slope of the normal would be asked. So you just to differentiate, get dy by dx and find the value at the given point, putting x and y some values, whatever values have been given, that gives you the slope of the tangent. To know the slope of the normal, take the reciprocal of the slope of the tangent and change the sign, that gives you the slope of the normal. So I can expect it for a 1 mark question. Now, using some condition given in the problem, we can get the points on the curve that can be expected for a 2 mark question. For a 3 mark question, one or two problems I did in the previous session also, and whatever I am working in today's session also, they are asked usually for a 3 mark question. Here, in these problems, what I am going to work out today, both the equations of both the tangent and the normal have to be calculated. So the common instruction is find the equations of the tangent and the normal. Here the point is given and also the equation of the curve will also be given. The first problem is y is equal to x to the power 4 minus 6x cube plus 13x square minus 10x plus 5. So find the equation of the tangent and the normal at this curve, x power 4 minus 6x cube plus 13x square minus 10x plus 5. The point is given at 1, 3. So at this particular point, see, the point is given, as usual, directly we first differentiate. Differentiate with respect to x, that is x to the power 4 becomes 4x cube minus 6 into x cube becomes 3x square plus 13 into x square becomes 2x plus minus 10 into 1 plus, for 5 being a constant, the derivative is 0. That is, dy by dx is equal to 4x cube minus 18x square plus 26x minus 10. Now, this is a derivative of the given function. Now, we want the slope at that particular point, 1, 3. So, how do you write that one? Dy by dx at 1, 3. Dy by dx at 1, 3. Wherever x is there is no y at all here. Wherever x is there, write the value 1. It is 4 into 1 cube minus 18 into 1 square plus 26 into 1 minus 10. So, on simplification, 4 minus 18 plus 26 minus 10. So, 26 plus 4 is 30, and 18 and 10 adding, it becomes minus 28, and the value is 2. Now, I told you that when you differentiate, get the value of dy by dx at a point, that always gives you the slope of the tangent. Therefore, you write slope of the tangent. Slope of the tangent is equal to 2. So as soon as you calculate the slope of the tangent, you start getting the equation of the tangent. Therefore, you write the equation of the tangent. And what's the point? The point has been given to you already at 1, 3. Equation of the tangent at 1, 3. What's the equation you have to use? Most of the problems, I've told you the slope point form. That is y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x1. Slope is 2, that is m, and the point x1, y1 have got the values 1 and 3 respectively. Therefore, using that equation, y minus y1 equal to 2 into x minus 1. That is, it's simple arithmetic now. Y minus 3 is 2x minus 2. Take them to the other side. It becomes 2x and minus 2. This will change the sign. Minus y plus 3 equal to 0. So, on further simplification, 2x minus y plus 1 equal to 0. Now, this is the equation of the tangent. Okay. It is the equation of the tangent. Of course, we have written already in the beginning. 2x minus y plus 1 is the equation of the tangent. Now, when the slope of the tangent has been calculated, what can be the slope of the normal? As you know that they are perpendicular to each other. Therefore, you write it as slope of the normal. It is, when that is 2, it is minus 1 by 2. That is the reciprocal of the slope of the tangent. And then you change the sign of that one. It is minus 1 by 2. Now the point is same, so there we calculated the equation of the tangent, here we are calculating the equation of the normal. Therefore, you write equation of the normal, the point is same, normal at 1, 3, at 1, 3, the same form of the equation, y minus 3 equal to minus 1 by 2 into x minus 1. Only the slope position is in the place of slope, no, the number is different. Now cross multiply, that is 2 into y minus 3, and this is minus of x minus 1. Remove the brackets. 2y minus 6 is minus x minus of minus plus. Take all of them to the same side. Minus x becomes plus x. Plus 2y already there, this is minus x, this also becomes minus, hence it is minus 7 equal to 0. So x plus 2y minus 7 equal to 0 is the equation of the normal. So usually these are, I told you already, that these are asked for the 3 mark question. So for getting the slope of the tangent, and of course, when you know the slope of the tangent, you can write the slope of the normal. Then getting the equation of tangent 1 mark and getting the equation of the normal. That's how usually the marks are allotted. For the differentiation part and getting the slope 1 mark. For each equation, 1 mark is allotted. It's a general allotment of the marks. Now, we move on to the another problem. But the procedure is same. But the type of function or the type of curve that is given to us will be different. So depending upon what type of curve is given, you have to remember how to find the derivative, then you have to get the derivative. Next one, if x is equal to cos t, find the equation of the tangent and the normal, that's a common instruction. X is equal to cos of t, y is equal to sin of t at the point t is equal to pi by 4. T is equal to pi by 4. Actually, such problems we had done in the one mark question category, we had done the given a parametric function, we had calculated the slope of the tangent. So how do you find the dy by dx when it is given in the parametric form? You have to differentiate both x and y with respect to the parameter, that is with respect to t in this case. So differentiate both x and y with respect to t, that is cos of t becomes minus sine of t. Similarly, dy by dt becomes sine of t becomes cos of t. But how do you find dy by dx here? You know the formula. Dy by dx equal to dy by dt divided by dx by dt. Dividing this by this, we get dy by dx. Write the actual values. Cos of t divided by minus sine of t. Now, using the basic information of trigonometry, cos theta by sin theta is cot theta or cot of t with the minus sign. So, we have done the differentiation, we got dy by dx. But we have to get the slope, that is dy by dx at t is equal to pi by 4. This is how we have to write the point, that is minus cot of pi by 4. What do you mean by pi by 4? 45 degrees, cot 45 is 1. Therefore, the slope of this one is minus 1. So, whenever we do the differentiation, we get the slope of the tangent always. So, the slope of the tangent, we got here 1, minus 1. So, slope of the tangent is minus 1 means, what can be the slope of the normal? As you know that, both the tangent and normal are perpendicular. to each other. And the condition for two lines to be perpendicular is the product of the slope should be equal to minus 1. When this is minus 1, automatically slope of the normal would be plus 1. So we got here slope of both the tangent and the normal. Look here, in the earlier problems, wherever we had calculated the equation of either the normal or the tangent, some point was given, or in the previous problem also point was given. Look at this problem. Here the function is given in the parametric form, isn't it? But the point is not given. We could calculate the value of dy by dx using the procedure for the parametric function. But we have to know the point also here. What do you mean by knowing the point? To find the coordinates of the point. That is important here. How do you find the value? You give the value t equal to pi by 4, where for x and y, x equal to cos t, y equal to sin t. Now, put x t is equal to pi by 4. Then, what is x is equal to? It is cos of pi by 4, that would be 1 by root of 2. And y is equal to sin of t, that is sin of pi by 4, that is also 1 by root of 2. Therefore, in this problem, the point has got the coordinates 1 by root 2 comma 1 by root of 2, x comma y. X comma y means 1 by root 2 comma 1 by root 2. So here in this problem, the point is not given because it's given in the parametric form. So using the fact that t is equal to pi by 4, we could calculate the point here. Now you can write equation of the tangent. Equation of the tangent, the point is given now. It is not given, we have calculated, so we know the point here. 1 by root of 2, comma 1 by root of 2. You have to be careful because it is an irrational number we are having. Okay. Now, write the formula. Y minus y1, 1 by root 2 equal to slope of the tangent is minus 1 into x minus x1. So, one calculation is extra. Now, it is y minus 1 by root of 2 multiply by the minus sign, it becomes minus x plus 1 by root of 2. See, don't cancel here because they are of different signs. Take the LCM on both the sides here. So, y into root of 2 minus 1, this is root 2 is the LCM again, it is minus x into root of 2 plus 1. Now you can cancel root of 2. Now take minus x into root of 2 to the left hand side. It becomes plus x into root of 2 plus y into root of 2 plus 1. When you take to the left hand side becomes minus 1. There is already another minus 1. So it is minus 2 equal to 0. Now this is the equation of the tangent. So it is x into root of 2 or root 2 into x, you can say x into root of 2 plus y into root of 2 minus 2 equal to 0 is the equation of the tangent. Now there the slope of the normal we know, now it is plus 1. Now the same procedure, therefore equation of the normal, the point is same. At the point 1 by root of 2 comma 1 by root of 2. So it is y minus 1 by root of 2 equal to 1 into x minus 1 by root of 2. That is y minus root of 2 equal to x minus root of 1 by root of 2. In this case, you can do the cancellation because the same quantities are present on both the sides with the same sign. If they are same sign, same value, you can cancel. Different sign, they have to be added up. So these two can be cancelled. Hence the line becomes y is equal to x. Or if you want, you can write it as x minus y equal to 0. Now remember, such equations always represent the lines passing through the origin. So y equal to x or x minus y equal to 0. That's the equation of the normal and this is the equation of the tangent. So when a parametric function is given, usually the point will not be given to you, okay? So to get the point means you have to get the coordinates of the point. What you have to do is you have to put that value of the parameter, maybe theta or t, whatever may be the parameter, you have to put that value in the expressions for x and y, then you will know the values of x and y, which are nothing but the coordinates of the point at which the tangent and the normal have been drawn. The next problem, y square equal to 4ax at the point at square comma 2at. I hope you remember this one. Actually, when I was teaching you the parametric function, the derivative of the parametric function, x equal to at square, y is equal to 2at. One problem I had given. Usually in the parametric function category, this is the first problem, because this being a rather simplest problem, usually this is the first problem we teach here. X equal to at square, y equal to 2at. See, same thing. They have been written together. They are nothing but the coordinates. That's what we did in the previous problem. I gave the value for t for both x and y. I got 1/√2, 1/√2. Those x and y were written together. They became the coordinates of the point. Here, they are written together. If you write them separately, x equal to at square, y equal to 2at. Now, this way of writing is called as the parametric representation of the parabola. I hope remember this one, first PUC I learned. It is the equation of a parabola. If you write them separately, it is called as the parametric representation of a parabola. That means that when you write these values for x and y, the equation gets satisfied. Now, when the point is given directly in the standard form, x1 comma y1, it is easier. But in the earlier problems, so these values were known to us. Here, in general, we had to do the calculation. Now, let us differentiate. Now, it is an implicit function. When you differentiate, y square becomes 2y and y becomes dy by dx, and it is 4a into 1. 4a being constant remains the same, x is 1 here. That means dy by dx would be equal to 4a divided by 2y. 2 1s are 2 2s are, you could cancel. 2a divided by y. Now, here you have to get the value at that particular point. Therefore, you write dy by dx, write it like this, at at square comma 2at. At square comma 2at will be, what is the derivative now? 2a by y at the same point, at square comma 2at. Without writing this step directly, you can write the value of y. 2a, what is y here? 2at. There is no x here. Therefore, 2a cancels. Hence, we have 1 by t. Now, the dy by dx value at this given point is equal to 1 by t. But you know that whenever we differentiate, the value of dy by dx, what we get at a given point, that always gives you the slope of the tangent. Therefore, the slope of the tangent is 1 by t. And equation of the tangent, the point is already given. It is at square comma 2at. At square comma 2at. Then, how do you find this one? The same procedure. Y minus y1. What is y1 here? 2at. That is equal to m. M means 1 by a, t into x minus x1, x minus at square. When the number is given, it's easier for you to do the calculation. But here, you have to be careful and express the answer in terms of t only. Now, cross multiply. That is, t into y minus 2at will be equal to x minus at square. Remove the brackets. It is t into y minus 2at into another t, 2at square, that is equal to x minus at square. You observe, here also at square, there also at square. Shift this to the right hand side. That is y into t, that is equal to x here minus at square. This becomes plus 2at square. Now, plus 2at square minus at square will be 1at square. So, yt would be equal to x plus at square. Now, this is the equation of the tangent. Now, the same thing here. when the slope of the tangent is 1 by t, what would be the slope of the normal? Take the reciprocal and change the sign. For 1 by t, the reciprocal is t, that is plus and this is minus. The point is same at at square comma 2at. See, this mechanical calculation, if you know how to solve one problem, the remaining problems would, only the data would be different, that's all. So this would be equal to y minus 2at, only in the position of the slope, the value would be different. It is x minus at square, that is y minus 2at, remove the brackets, minus t into x, minus of minus plus at cube. Here don't have any simplification, just to take xt to the left hand side, it becomes a plus. So x into t, keep this y as it is, take this to the right hand side, it becomes positive, 2at plus at cube. Generally, we express the equation in this particular form. So this is the equation of the tangent and that is the equation of the normal. For this curve, it is a parabola, as you know, at the given point at square comma 2at. Now, this is a procedure you have to remember. So whenever an equation of a curve is given, and suppose a point is given directly, or you may have to calculate, first differentiate the function, find dy by dx, and at that point calculate the value of dy by dx, that always gives you the slope of the tangent. Now, when the point is given, you can use the formula y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x1, and simplification gives you the equation of the tangent. After getting the equation of the tangent, to get the equation of the normal, first you have to get the slope of the normal. So when you know the slope of the tangent, take the reciprocal and change the sign, that gives you the slope of the normal, and using the same form of the equation of the straight line, y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x1, because the point is also same, you simplify and you get the equation of the normal. So whatever may be the type of function that is given, differentiation important. That's why in differentiation I taught you all types of functions, so that whatever may be the type of function you come across, you will know how to find the derivative of the function. Now the next problem is little bit different here. I am not calculating the equation of the tangent or the normal. I am not getting the equation of the tangent or the normal here. See, here two curves are given to us. Two curves are given to us, and the condition, some particular answer is expected. So first I will write the problem, you will know how to solve the problem then. Prove that the curves x is equal to y square and xy is equal to k cut at right angles if 8k square equal to 1. See, generally the problem is asked like this, that is, there are two curves here, if they cut at right angles, actually this has to be proved, but usually the problem is given like this, prove that the curves cut at right angles, taking this to be the data, the curves are cutting each other at right angles, that is, they are at 90 degrees to each other. You have to prove this result. Don't take this and prove that one. The problem usually asks like this, but this is the data and this has to be proved. First, let us know what you mean by cut at right angles. See, we are familiar with the two lines being perpendicular to each other, isn't it? When the lines are like this, we say they cut at right angles or they are perpendicular to each other, isn't it? That means the angle between the two lines would be equal to 90. Then we say they are perpendicular or they cut at right angles when they are intersecting like this. Now here the curves are cut at right angles. See, here one information I want to give, then I will work out the problem. See, suppose the curves are like this. See, this is one curve, this is another curve. This is the point of intersection. Now, there may be more than one point of intersection also. This is the one point of intersection. Now, you draw the tangent to both the curves. See, whenever we say the right angle, when we think about the right angle, it is always between two lines. But here the curves are at right angles, it is asked. The meaning is, the definition is actually, when two curves are said to be perpendicular to each other, or they cut at right angles, or mathematically we use the word orthogonal. That is a word, technical word we have to use. Two curves are orthogonal to each other if the tangents drawn at the point of intersection, they are perpendicular to each other. When we say about the perpendicularity, it has to be between two lines, two straight lines. So when the curves are cutting, we say the curves are at right angles. The curves cut at right angles or the curves are orthogonal. All of them give the same meaning. Say, when does it happen? When the tangent, this is the point of intersection. At the point of intersection, I have done tangent to this one, I have drawn tangent to the second curve also. And what is the angle here? You observe that it is equal to 90 degrees. Always this angle need not be 90. It can be an acute angle also, it can be an obtuse angle also. Only when the angle is 90, we say they cut at right angles. That means two curves cut at right angles if the angle between the tangents drawn at the point of intersection are perpendicular to each other. So here the tangents have been drawn, and here we come to the condition of the perpendicularity. What's the condition? When two lines are perpendicular, the product of their slopes should be equal to minus 1. Using that condition, we can show that 8k square equal to 1. Understand? For that, when the tangent is drawn, you know that when we differentiate a function, you always get the slope of the tangent. So differentiate both the curves. The point is not given here. Differentiate both the curves and then find dy by dx. You take the slope of the first one as m1, second one as m2, or m and m dash also you can take. Then use the condition that the curves are at perpendicular to each other. Therefore, multiply the two slopes here. Then you get some data. Using whatever answer you get, you have to try to prove that 8k square equal to 1 using the equations of the curves also. First, let me start with the curves here and let me give the number for them. X is equal to y square. Given, x is equal to y square, and take this as 1, and then other one is xy is equal to k. We need both this one, so I have given some number for this one. X equal to y square, you can write, let x be equal to y square, be the first curve, and xy equal to k be the second curve. Now differentiate this one. Differentiate always with respect to x. So 1 would be equal to 2y into dy by dx. Y square becomes 2y, y becomes dy by dx. That is, dy by dx is equal to 1 by 2y. That is, I have differentiated. So what does this give you? It gives us the slope of the tangent for the first curve. Similarly, you differentiate. How do you differentiate? You can see that it is a product. So, to apply the product rule, x into dy by dx plus y into 1, k being a constant equal to 0. Therefore, dy by dx would be equal to, shifting it to the other side, we get y minus y minus x. Now, this is the slope of the tangent for the first curve. This is the slope of the tangent to the second curve. Let me consider this as m and that as m dash, or you can take it as m1 and m2 also. Both, whatever may be that one, take two different notations here, that's all. Now write here, given that the curves are at right angles. The curves cut, you write. The curves cut at right angles. The curves cut at right angles. The tangents at that point, the tangents at that point are perpendicular. That is the meaning of that one. Or perpendicular. The tangents at that point are perpendicular. That is the product of their slopes. Product of their slopes should be equal to minus 1. Product of these two should be equal to minus 1. But how you have denoted? That is m into m dash should be equal to minus 1. Now what are m and m dash? We have denoted that as 1 by 2y into minus y by x is equal to minus 1. Now cancel minus sign. Y can be cancelled. So what is remaining? 1 by 2x is equal to 1. Correct? Now on cross multiplication, you can write it as x is equal to 1 by 2. Taking x here, x becomes 1 by 2. Now we want the answer in terms of k. So k is present in the second one. First we have to say, I have got the value of x to be equal to 1 by 2. Using the first curve, let me find the value of y also. Then substitute both the values here in the second equation, you will be getting the result that is required. Now write, put x is equal to half in the first result. So what is that one? Half is equal to y square. That implies y is equal to 1 by root of 2, or if you want you can write plus or minus also. Anyway, we are squaring afterwards. Even if you write only 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2, it is okay. So for x 1 by 2, y is 1 by root of 2. Now put x is equal to half and y is equal to 1 by root of 2 in which equation? In the second equation, which involves the k. That is 1 by 2 into 1 by root of 2 is equal to k. Since the answer is having square, k square, square both sides. When you square both sides here, 1 by 2, 2 becomes 4, correct? And root 2 becomes 2. That is right hand side is k square. Now 4 2s are 8. And if you cross multiply, 8k square is equal to 1. Now this is the required answer which has been asked here in the problem to prove. That is, when this condition is satisfied, when the two curves are at right angles, when the two curves cut at right angles, then we can say that 8k square would be equal to 1. Of course, in the question, they cut at right angles if 8k square is equal to 1. That is how the problem is asked. But you cannot take 8k square equal to 1, get the result. But the procedure is, you take the two curves here, differentiate and find the respective slopes of both the tangents, multiply them, equate it to minus 1 because they are perpendicular to each other, and then getting the values of both x and y using the given function or the equations of the curve, you arrive at the result 8k square equal to 1. So these are the problems I have worked out under the first application, that is about the tangent and the normal. So in the next session, I am starting the next application of the derivative, that is application of dy by dx in the next session. Thank you.